Are your sales reps holding on to problems too long? Hi, I'm Jim Pancero, helping you become a stronger leader of your sales team. I remember back in my early days of selling, back when I was in my early 20s, I was a sales representative for the IBM Corporation, their large computer division. So I was assigned a couple key accounts that I was supposed to maintain and grow their business. One of these accounts was really tough. He was obnoxious. He'd love to yell at salespeople and to give people a hassle because usually it gave him some kind of discount or financial break. So he was a terror of our office to deal with. Well, they assigned him to me. Now, I was working with him for about 6 months and I thought I was doing a great job. I thought I was taking care of everything. I bring our branch manager out for their annual visit just to say hi, thank him for the business, and get feedback. I was not allowed in this meeting. So as we're driving back to the office, I said, so what did Charlie, my customer, say? And I was really shocked by manager. He said, hey, he really appreciates you're working hard for him and he appreciates that. He knows you care about his business and you're trying to do the right thing. I was very proud. I said, well, that's what I've been trying to do. He said, but he had a big complaint and it's a really big one. I was surprised. What's the complaint? He said, you're holding on to problems too long. I remember laughing, saying, isn't that my job as a sales rep? Aren't I supposed to handle problems? My branch manager says, no, that's not your job. Your job is to use your entire team to handle problems. And Charlie's complaint is, you hold on to a problem too long trying to solve it yourself to finally get the resources you need to get it done. So problems, when they do occur, are taking longer to get solved than they would otherwise. And my branch manager says, Jim, you need to start using your entire team. You're not a solo player out there. You have a team behind you. It's time you start using it. That had a major impact on me. I was shocked by that and really took that as a refocus of what I was doing and how I did my job as a sales rep. How many of your sales reps have that same attitude I did, that their job is to handle everything and hold on to a problem as long as possible before they ask for help, because asking for help is considered a sign of weakness in the sales rep and what they're doing? Look at all these challenges and biases. So look how problems linger before they really get the help and address the efforts they need because of getting management or technical expertise involved. What can you do to have this discussion with your team? Just to make sure they understand their job is not to hold on to problems. Their job is to use their team to get the best resources and solutions for your customers. Because when we do that, we increase our competitive advantage and we increase our success in selling. What can you do to work with your people to make sure they're not holding on to problems too long, that it's not seen as a sign of weakness to bring a manager a problem a customer's having, and that it's using the entire team to increase your competitive edge? Would love to know what your team thinks about this and what you're doing about it as their manager. And as always, thanks for watching.